If you've already set up your Pebble with the fan-supported Rebel service, but now your watch cannot interact with your phone calls, this is what you need to do to regain control. To watch my video on how to set up your Pebble with the Rebel service, link in the description. To get full control, you'll need to install Dialer for Rebel. It may also show up as Dialer for Pebble. Just be sure it's from Barclays. Open up your Pebble app, and in the Apps tab, click on the plus icon to add an app. Search for Dialer for Pebble. This is how it will look like. Add it to your Pebble apps so that it will be installed on your watch. Next, you will need to get the companion app that goes on your phone. Go ahead, click Get It Now, and it'll take you to the Play Store link. If your phone is still compatible, you can install it directly from the Play Store. However, newer versions of Android will show it as an incompatible app. So the alternate choice would be to sideload it from a trusted source. I usually go to APK Gear to get my sideloads. Link is in the description. You should always use caution and scan your phone with a malware or antivirus scanner afterwards. Now that the Dialer app is installed, open it up and it'll go through the process of asking you to approve of its permissions. Then it'll ask you to add it to your list of Pebble apps. Go ahead and do this even though it's already been added. It doesn't hurt anything, just to go through the routine. Now the app shows you have two things to take care of, the notifications service and the Do Not Disturb access. Fixing the notifications access will also clear the Do Not Disturb flag. So go ahead and enable the notifications access. But if you have Android 13, you will first need to manually allow restricted settings for the Dialer for Rebel app. So the quick way to do this is to just pull down your notifications panel twice, hit the gears icon, and go into setup, then hit apps, and the Dialer app should be the first one listed. Then on the right corner, click on the three dots menu to expand allow restricted settings. You'll need to verify your credentials and you'll get a confirmation that you have allowed restricted settings. Now with that done, go back to the Dialer for Rebel app. I like to just use the recent apps button or gesture and go back to the Dialer quickly, and now you can enable the notifications access. Once that's done, back out into the main Dialer for Pebble app. It will tell you next to disable phone calls in your Pebble app, so you won't get duplicate notifications. Go into your main Pebble app and go to the rightmost tab for notifications. Scroll down to phone calls and toggle it off. The next thing that needs to be done is to change the way the decline call function operates. The default setting here sends the wrong command. So go back into your Dialer app, go to the menu on the top left and click on General Settings. Scroll to the bottom and click on Decline Button Text. The default uses the command Dismiss. It needs to be changed to Decline. Do so and hit OK. Now you are all done with the basic settings to get this app working properly. You can go through the other settings on your own and set it up to the way you like it, like how the buttons behave during an incoming call, or what is displayed. Or the vibration patterns. The last thing to do is to make sure the app does not get killed in the background when the phone is locked, or if the app is not in the foreground. So pull down the notification panel twice again, go into the settings through the gear icon, go into apps. Click on Dialer for Pebble, go to battery and choose unrestricted. This will prevent it from getting killed in the background. Also, depending on your Android version, make sure the pause app activity, if unused, is disabled.
You should do this for the Pebble app also.
That's it. Now you should be able to answer or decline your phone calls through your Pebble Watch, or do many other things, like answer with a speakerphone, or simply mute the phone.